Good morning. Council members, thank you for coming together on short notice. We are here to fulfill the requirements in the ordinance code regarding declaration of emergency I issued at 12 a.m. this morning. First, I'd like to recognize and talk to you about the incredible men and women who serve our city. Over the last several days, they have been working around the clock to prepare our community for what's coming in the days ahead. Joining our team locally are state and federal partners. We have excellent lines of communication and support at every level. In the last 48 hours, we've seen Dorian strengthen to a Category 5 hurricane. And if you've seen the news from the Bahamas, this is a very, very serious storm. While it slowly moves west from the Bahamas, we know that it will eventually turn north. The experts we rely on predict the turn sometime late this evening or into tomorrow morning. Until it does make that turn, the exact path and exact proximity to Northeast Florida will be a forecast made with the best information available. It will still be hours until we know its exact path. Regardless of Dorian's strength offshore of our local coast, dangerous hazards, including tropical storm force winds, storm surge, and flooding rainfall threats will remain the same. This possibility that we take the next day and a half to take every precaution we can and work to keep people safe. For that reason, effective last night at midnight, I signed a proclamation declaring a local state of emergency. This declaration allows my administration and local officials to have the resources they need to make us ready and prepare us for any necessary recovery efforts in its aftermath. As of now, all City of Jacksonville offices will be closed Tuesday and Wednesday. Yesterday afternoon, Superintendent Green also announced Duval County Public Schools will be closed Tuesday and Wednesday. All of these closures for Tuesday and Wednesday may be added as we learn more and understand local impacts of this storm. Effective at 8 a.m. this morning, I initiated a mandatory evacuation for zones A and B. Anyone in Jacksonville who lives in zones A and B should be using today and tomorrow to make all necessary preparations to leave zones A and B. In almost any scenario that plays out with this powerful hurricane, there will be effects to the coastal and low-lying areas of our city. These evacuations include Huguenot and Hannah Parks, which fall into Zone A, so this morning we have begun camper evacuations, and Tuesday and Wednesday, the parks will be closed. Shelters officially opened at 10 a.m. today, but have been available to receive evacuees since 8 a.m. These shelters include certain locations to serve those with special medical needs, and certain locations are pet friendly. People looking for information on shelters, including locations and what they need to bring, should go to jacksready.com, install the Jacks Ready app, or call 630-CITY. Emergency operations personnel are coordinating transportation needs for the shelters through JTA, our Jacksonville Transportation Authority. The St. John's River Water Taxi has suspended operations, and the city will be notified when they reopen. It's important to note that personnel at the Emergency Operations Center are in direct contact with hospitals and assisted living facility managers, both public and private. We are committed to assisting the most vulnerable in our community as this storm progresses. Again, I want to thank you, council members, for your support and assistance in informing our citizens and preparing the city. Many of us have been through this before. We are prepared, and we will do everything together to keep the people of our city safe. If you have questions or need additional information, my administration will remain available as long as you need them. With me this morning are key staff members to answer any questions you have.